Another technique which again was started by Misha Sakhara relates to application of diet, because when I visited and when I trained two groups of students 2 years ago, what happened there, one of our students had a very large brain cancer, yes. Brain tumor,
yeah,
and Misha was kind of, apart from breathing training, started to study what type of diet used by doctors.
Yeah.
And a lot of research actually can be found online and can be found in medical articles. For example, with application of fasting that was common many decades ago,
yes.
Because doctors discovered that cancer cells, they thrive on blood glucose. So when
yeah.
our blood glucose is rising, especially after meals, and when people have too high blood glucose for eating sugar and carbs and so on, that actually promotes growth of cancer cells.
Yeah.
So therefore, these doctors many decades ago, they noticed that when people go fasting, I'm talking about water fasting, which can be of course quite long, maybe 15, 20, 30 days probably would be close to maximum, because people lose the body weight, the body fat, and fasting longer than that is quite dangerous because people get just too slim. But what we found generally is that going into fasting triggers a special state, which is called ketosis.
Yeah.
Why? Because we have very limited amount of carbohydrates. We have carbs stored in our liver, muscle, glycogen.
Mm-hmm.
It's quite a small
sure.
amount. If we go running, it lasts no more than 2 hours.
Exactly.
And we are done with glycogen. If we don't run, we gradually...
That's why they eat. And then you look at Tour de France or so, they start to eat after...
Yes, yeah, of course.
Long drinks.
Not those who use ketogenic diet these days. Yeah, there are like very smart athletes as well who know how to use their body fat, so it's kind of a big topic for sports to discuss. But what we're talking about cancer here is that we discovered that actually ketones in blood, we are able to suppress certain types of cancer cells.
Yeah.
So that's kind of additional effect.
And this is what happens when you fast.
Not,
when
yes,
you
exactly.
Very low carbs.
That was fasting approach, and the studies done in 1920s, 30s. But doctors noticed, and more recent as well, that the application of fasting allows people to reduce the cancer tumor size. So many cancer can be inoperable, so doctors cannot cut. So it's one more people just afraid of occurrence of new growth of new cancer tumors, because it's very common thing for people to have. Doctors cut one tumor and it appears nearby or even some other parts of the body. So it commonly happens. And we believe that it happens because of too low body oxygen level, because according
on
to
Soviet
research, yes, plus diet. So we discussed briefing part, Soviet doctors, what we did, and amazing results, in my view, best even known clinical trial on cancer, which we discussed with briefing pre-training. Now, in relation to diet, there is a problem with fasting. You cannot fast for many months.
No.
So, well, overweight, severely overweight, maybe can go for 2 months. But it's kind of really hard. So what happens here is that we need to find a solution when we do not rise blood sugar level, but people still get energy, so they can function normally. So the solution then, of course, to cut carbohydrates, that we take out all starches, we cut grains, potatoes, like all this rice, wheat, corn, oats, and so on. And plus, in addition, of course, fruits, because fruits can give you quite a big contribution. Maybe avocado would be like an exceptional fruit, but most fruits are sweet. So they would give also rise in the blood sugar, and that feeds cancer cells. So, but if we use low carbohydrate or cold therapeutic ketogenic diet, which may be at the level most commonly, doctors would use 20 grams a day, no more than 20 grams of carbs, that naturally makes you carbohydrate sources would quickly go to nothing. It takes some a while to adapt, maybe 1, 2, 3 weeks time, depending on the stress level,
yes.
On the CP results as well. And what happens later, the body kind of is forced to use their own fat resources.
Yeah.
And fat resources that we have are like 100 times bigger,
of course,
in terms of size, because we have a lot of fat. The problem is, when we are eating carbs all the time, we can rely only on carbs, and the fat resources are inaccessible. Because the body, kind of my understanding, is trying to burn glucose first, because it's much more dangerous substance for the body to have within.
Yeah.
So glucose, kind of, if we think about like from evolutionary viewpoint, is exceptionally ancient or old chemical, which is present even like in reptiles or fish.
Mm-hmm.
So if you take, for example, a fish and catch a fish, like wild fish, or catch a reptile, like some lizard, but which were living like 400 million years ago, like half billion years ago, what happens with them when we are caught, when we are under stress? Their blood sugar level actually spikes. Mm. Even though we may not eat, we do not eat carbohydrates, because in wild we just eat another fish, we eat grass and so on, but glucose is present in blood of even simple animals like fish and reptiles, so simple creatures. And so therefore it's kind of a natural substance which are naturally present in the blood of different creatures. But it's again, it's kind of an emergency chemical, and humans started to use agriculture and use carbohydrates a lot in their diet, starting from about 10,000 years ago, and depending on the place on the earth, some tribes, some original people may not have much carbs even now, but it started to rise a lot, and of course in the Western world it's staple food, kind of people use it as a main energy source, and that also rises a situation when body needs to deal with a lot of carbs every day. Yeah. And because of that, the body kind of trying to get rid of carbs first, storing fat and using carbs sooner. So converting it to fat, some of it. And so therefore, the idea which relates to kind of, to use similar effect to fasting, is to use a diet which would be very low in carbs, because the effect, physiological effect, would be then similar to fasting in a way that blood sugar level would be kept at the lower level, and the human body can use ketones as a main source of energy.
So but there's also the possibility to do something like intermittent fasting as well,
yeah,
like or only to have a nutritional window. This would also enhance the build-up of ketones in the body. So there are also other possibilities to get the ketone level high,
yes, absolutely,
and the blood sugar relatively low. And another thing I want to add here, you can go on then, but just to have another perspective, I myself am on a ketogenic diet since a little bit more than 1 year, and I just want to mention it, it's not that difficult if you know what to do, and if you maybe read some books or have some friends who do it, because you can eat quite nice food. It's not like maybe 100 years ago or so it was really, really bad to be on a ketogenic diet, because of what they eat at this time was sometimes could be very horrible. But those these days are it has changed a bit. Today we can eat almost anything. I eat noodles, for example, made from zucchini, or I eat pizza. Like it's possible even without
low carb.
Pizza.
Yeah, we have specialty foods, but there is much more variety, it's true, of vegetables and access of different products.
Because sometimes people are really scared, oh, ketogenic diet and no more carbs, I cannot eat anything anymore. That's definitely not true. You can eat very nice kind of foods and cook very well on ketogenic diet, just to mention it here.
Yeah, the most important part, I believe, it's long-term effects, long-term benefits that people can get from diet, of course, and yes, it's... But it's a huge topic itself, which we're not going to go into
sure.
Effects of ketones, because what we are discussing here, what we are kind of trying to, the topic that we have right now is cancer.
Exactly.
And so therefore...
We have oxygen and we have sugar.
And we have, exactly.
So
this is factors,
and
so these factors, exactly, these are factors that low oxygen and high glucose, we have both, would be factors, two central factors, which allows cancer tumors to grow and appear and grow. And therefore, if we address both of them, yeah, that's makes
the same time
much more effective technique. And that's actually, we are going to, there were news recently that now it's like 2017, January, there were recently news that doctors were organizing clinical trials on the application of ketogenic diet on cancer, because probably it would be the first trial, because so far like, there were just reports, kind of, and the reports about fasting, reports about like individual cases when they applied the diet. But it seems that there is more interest, and that would be, of course, definitely a great thing, because very serious condition. So we have two very good solutions for cancer, and again, briefly training, in my view, it actually still remains a central part, because ketogenic diet allows people to have better, easier.
Exactly.
And so that move the SCP to the higher zone, and then according to the Buteyko table of health zones, according to the research which was done by Buteyko doctor, that's a central factor that makes the immune system very powerful. So it recovers and then it starts to attack the malignant cells, and that allows people to make tumor disappear or prevent cancer in the long run, to have a healthy lifestyle, to have healthy normal life.
Definitely.